Okay, so to start off this tutorial, we are going to be starting with a slip knot. Slip knot is really easy to make, just like that. So this tutorial will apply to large size and extra large size dogs. The difference is the size of the hook, and that is about it. I'm going to be chaining 13 for a total of 12. By that I mean I'm going to chain a total of 13. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. We have 13 chains here. And single crochet into the second chain from the hook. So right in there. So we are going to single crochet into the second chain from the hook. There's 1, 2, 3, 4. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. So you will have a total of 12 stitches. Okay, so for row 2, we are going to chain 1 and you're going to turn your work. Turning your work, we are going to be working in the back loops. The back loops are right here. If you turn your work to the side, you see these V's right here? Those are your back loops. So this is a back loop right there. That is a back loop. And we are going to work into those back loops right there. And then pull through. So that is your first stitch. Work again in the back loops again. There's 2, there's 2, there's 3. Remember, we're not working through the 2 loops, we're working through the back. So there's 3, 4, 5. Six, and then there's 7, 8, 9, 10, and then 11, and we will have one more left, which is going to look like it's a shy stitch, but you're going to go into that for number 12. Remember, working into the back loops only, and then pull that through. So you have 2 rows right here of single crochet in the back loops of your band for the neck. Chain 1, turn again, and repeat the process, okay? So you're going to be repeating this from row 2 all the way to row 64. You are going to make 64 rows of back loop single crochets. And you're going to go back and forth. Just chain 1, single crochet in the back loops, and do that all the way until you get to row 64. when you get to row 64, you can either finish off and sew your ends together, because we're going to be working in the rounds after, or you can slip stitch them together, and when you get to the end, chain one and then get ready for our rounds. And what I'm going to do is slip stitch mine to join. I'm not going to finish off, but it's really up to you what you want to do. So keep repeating this process for 63 more rows, and we will meet back when we get the length of the dog's neck. So the band is going to measure approximately 18 to 19 inches. Mine measures 18 inches long. So my brother's dog, and he's Siberian Husky, he measures 18 inches around the neck, and this stretches a lot, as you can see. So it's not really important that, you know, it's exactly 18 inches. If you get a little bit under 18 inches, that's fine. So what I'm going to do is get this side, and I'm going to slip stitch to join. This side and this side, and hold it together like so. And you want to make sure that they're properly put up close to each other. And we're going to slip stitch to the first single crochet, and we are going to chain one. Okay, now you can turn your work back towards you, and now we can either slip stitch to join, or we can single crochet to join. I think I'm going to single crochet this together. There's one. Make sure that they're lined up next to each other as much as possible, so then you have the correct amount of numbers. There's one. There's two. There's three. There's four. Five. And into our last stitch for our 12th stitch right here. So go ahead and single crochet, and there you have it. So it's gonna kind of poke out just like as if, you know, it were one of the ribbing. Okay, so now we are working in the rounds, no more rows, and we are going to chain, we will be chaining one. And this looks like two because I was crocheting from here, but it's actually just one. So take your tail, put it right behind there, and single crochet into the same stitch as the chain up one. We will be putting one single crochet into each row for a total of 64. Three, four, five. There's five right there. There's six. There's seven. There's eight. And nine. And ten. And 11. And 12. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Okay, so we should have a total of 64. So there's 60, 61, 62, 63, and 64. So you want to have a total of 64. So make sure that you have a total of 64. Okay. So we are going to be slip stitching into the first single crochet, which is right there. So we are going to slip stitch the join to the first single crochet, which is right there. This is what your band should look like, and we are working in rounds, and you can cut this off as well. And we will be working double crochets. We will be using chain ones this tutorial. We are not using chain twos or chain threes. If you are more comfortable using chain twos or chain threes, go ahead. For my double crochets, I try to not use chain threes because they tend to leave a line on the sweater. I don't want to do that. So I use chain ones. Okay. Not too many people do that, but I like to do it. It's something that I'm comfortable with. So go ahead and pick the chain number that you want to use, because it doesn't change it anyways, because the chain doesn't count as anything. So whether you're doing a 1, 2, or 3 chain, the chain itself is not going to count. Okay. So we're going to start off with double crocheting all the way around, and we're only putting one. So into that same stitch that we just chained one, okay, this is going to be our first stitch. And we are always going to be slip stitching into the first double crochet. Never join to the chain one. So we are going to be double crocheting all the way around for a total of 64 stitches. So we should have 64 double crochets. So everybody should know how to do a double crochet. If not, there are a lot of helpful videos out there that can show you how to do a double crochet. So we're only putting one double crochet all the way around. So continue to place one double crochet all the way around, and we will come back. I am back. I'm here at the end, and I am slip stitching to the first double crochet. And you should have a total of 64 double crochets. For round 2 all the way to round 4, we are going to continue this. Crochet into the same stitch as a chain 1, because chain 1 counts as nothing. And continue in this fashion to double crochet around. And everything that I am doing applies to the extra large size as well. There's nothing that changes except the size hook and of course the yarn. Because if you're doing a extra large size sweater and you need a yarn that calls for a 6.5 millimeter crochet hook, I believe Red Heart with Love has yarns that call for a 6.5, and it also might be a lot more comfortable on your dog, oops, to use a softer yarn anyways. But of course, it's really up to you what yarn you want to use. So go ahead and finish this row all the way to round 4, and we will when we come to the end of round 4, oops again, we will be changing colors to the color buff or whatever color that you want, unless you are working with one color. Okay, so I am back, and I am at the end of the round of round 4. And now, before you slip stitch to join, okay, you're not going to slip stitch just yet. but you are going to change your color if you are following along. I am using the color buff. So I am going to be switching my color to this color. And this is buff. Just want to get it out there. So the pattern here in this round is going to be one double crochet in the first two stitches. After that, we are going to increase by placing two double crochets into that stitch. After that, we will repeat one double crochet in the next two stitches. And then after that, we place two double crochets here for an increase. Then two double crochets in the next two stitches, and then two double crochets into the same stitch for an increase. So this whole round, we will be repeating the same thing. So go ahead and finish this round. I will be back in a moment, and we will end with a total of 86 stitches. So here's an increase, and therefore after we will be placing one double crochet into the next two stitches. I am back from increasing, and I accidentally misread my writing on my notepad. You will have a total of 85 stitches, not 86. You will have a total of 85 stitches in this round, not 86. Okay, so now you're going to chain up one, and we are on round six. I wanted to mention that I am going to be changing colors every four rows. So it's not necessary to change colors every row. It's really up to you how often you want to change your colors. So, or even if you're using one color, that's fine. You don't have to do anything if you're not changing colors. From round six all the way to round nine, we are going to be double crocheting around. So go ahead and chain one, double crochet into the same stitch. So from here on, just go ahead and place one double crochet into every stitch around for a total of 85 stitches. So I will leave you guys to it. Didn't intend this video to be too long because this sweater is so easy, it's ridiculous. I mean, it is so beginner friendly, and it's the stitches are simple, and basically all you're doing is double crocheting and just changing colors. That's all you're doing. And at least after you make the armholes, and that's all you're doing. It's just working on the back and the stomach, and that's all you're doing. But it's really long. That's the only thing about making a large size dog sweater, is you're spending more time, you know, crocheting on the back. And this time it's a one piece. You're not, you are finishing off at the belly to work on the back, but that's about it. You're not making a belly strap this time. I know sometimes big dogs are harder to get underneath and to put the strap under. And my brother's dog is the type of dog where you either put a sweater on him with no belt, or you don't put a sweater on him at all because he does not like to be messed with, really. At least lately, he's been really grouchy, not in the sweater mood. So go ahead and complete your next two rows of double crochet, because we are, again, working four rows of each color. So we have 6, 7, 8, and 9. So there's, when we get to the end of round 9, we will be changing colors before we go to round 10. So I'll be back just a moment. I am back, and I've come to the end of round 9. Okay, so there's 6, 7, 8, 9. And now we are going to be creating the armholes of the dog's arms. And I'm just going to take my color in coffee. Okay, I'm going to take this color. It's just a dark brown color. Oh, that got in there. Yeah, I'm going to change the color to that. Chain one. And we are going to be... We are going to double crochet into the first 10 stitches. So go in here and double crochet. That's your first. Working over your tails. Double crochet into the next 9 stitches. One, two, three, four, trying to hide this tail as I go along. One, two, three, four, five. 6, 7, 8, 9. Whoops. There's 9. Pull some more color. And there's 10 double crochets. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We're going to chain up a total of 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. So we chained up 16. I'm going to move these scissors. We have 16 chains and we're going to skip a total of 14 stitches and into the 15th stitch with a double crochet. So counting from this chain up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So there's 10. 11, 12, 13, 14. So into the stitch, we are going to double crochet to join into the 15th stitch there. Okay, now we are going to double crochet into the next 46 stitches. Now we are going to chain up a total of 16 stitches. So there's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. Okay, so we are going to double crochet to join, skipping a total of 14 stitches and into the 15th stitch, which this is the 15th stitch. Skipping a total of 14, and this is the 15th stitch. So, double crochet, skipping a total of 14 stitches. Okay, so there's... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and to the 15th stitch. Okay, so slip stitch to the first double crochet. And I know this color is rather dark, that's why I used a white background. Let me know if you like the white background better. And so now we are going to just chain one, and we're just going to double crochet around. And you are going to repeat this from round 11 all the way to 27, changing colors every four. And let me just explain this. If you were doing this tutorial the way I did, because you like the colors, the color coordinates, I changed colors every four. So I did four of cafe latte, four of buff, and I always do two of coffee. So only use two rows of coffee. So just double crochet around, and when you go over this chain, you are going to put 16 double crochets into that little chain. So there's one double crochet, and we're going to place 15 more double crochets over the chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 15, and 16. So put a total of 16 double crochets over the arms. Now continue to double crochet all the way around. Go ahead and continue to double crochet around, and you're only putting one double crochet. And when you go to the other side, you will repeat what you did on this side, putting a total of 16 double crochets over the 16 chain. Cafe latte again. So switch your color again to cafe latte. You're going to start working on the body now. So what we're doing is, this is our arms and this is our chest area. So this is going to be facing down on the dog. This right here, let me go ahead and pull that out really quick. Let's look at this for a second. So this is our dog sweater. This is the back, which is going to be the body. So this is back. This is front. Okay, so this is our stomach. And we have our armholes right here, which is probably hard for you to tell because it's so dark. So, moving on, we are going to be double crocheting around from round 11 to 27. And that's when we finish off after round 27. We finish off on round 27, and then we will start working on the rest of our back. So I'm going to do this last round with you, because all you're doing is double crocheting, and this is the biggest part of the project, is double crocheting and changing colors constantly. This is what we are going to keep on doing. You are going to keep working just one double crochet in the same fashion. You are not doing anything else but double crocheting. Really simple. I told you guys that this pattern was very easy, and the only thing is the sweater does work up really quickly because you are using double crochets. However, if you're using a half double crochet, it's going to be taking you a little longer. So let me back out here so you guys can see what I'm doing. I hope everyone had a fabulous Thanksgiving. I had a wonderful Thanksgiving. It was me and my family, my husband and my son, and my in-laws joined my parents and my family for Thanksgiving this year. It was really wonderful, and I couldn't be any more blessed. Like I say on my ring right here, I wear this ring all the time because I really am blessed to be here, be alive, and be healthy. And that's all that really matters at the end of the day, as long as you and your loved ones are healthy. I myself had a health scare recently. I'm a kidney transplant recipient, which is why I say I'm so blessed. I've hit 1 year of being off dialysis, and I'm very young to be going through what I'm going through. I am 28. I was on dialysis for a year, and then I found out my brother was my match. So my brother donated his kidney to me, and I've been living life ever since. And I found out that my kidney had, I found out that my kidney was starting to look a little off, and it was a health scare for me because I thought that I was going to lose my transplant. But I went to the doctors and they told me that everything was fine, that my kidney had a little oopsie, but it was okay, that my kidney went back to its normal range. I don't know if anybody out there has had a transplant, but it's very important that you take care of yourself and that you appreciate your kidneys, because you don't realize how much you have until it's taken away. So keep crocheting around. All I am doing is placing one double crochet, and that's what we will continue to do until we get to row 27. And of course, if you are following this tutorial and this color pattern that I am doing, you will just keep repeating what you've done so far. So the cafe latte, buff, and then coffee, and then cafe latte, and then after this we will be putting on buff, and that's every four rows of these colors, and then of coffee, two rows of double crochet. So I will meet you guys in just a moment when I complete my rows up to row 27. Hey everybody, so I'm back after completing all of my rows. So this is what the sweater looks like so far. Let me kind of back up here so you guys can see it. So this is the stomach area so far. And as you can see, by using the chain ones, you hardly get a line. It makes a really nice line. So this is why I use the chain one. Okay, so I have completed 28 rows instead of 27 because of the color. And I just, you know, it's not necessary. If you just want to do 25, 26, 27 and just stop there, go ahead. But I added one more row just for the sake of the colors, so it doesn't throw my colors off. So this is the stomach area again. And we are going to be using a stitch marker here to mark exactly where we're going to start crocheting around, because now we're focusing on the back. Majority of this is already the back right here. You see how this is like the back of the sweater? Looks cute. I love the colors so far. So we're gonna be working and making the rest of the back, because you know, you don't want the dog to pee on the sweater. So you know, the bottom can only go so far. So you want to make sure that this part is straight as possible when you pull up the sweater, because you don't want the sweater to look crooked on your dog. So I'm making this as straight as I can. And here is where I finished off, right there. And you can either tuck this in now or you can tuck it in later. But I'm going to just leave that for later, because I'm going to be crocheting around anyways in the end. So I'm going to use a stitch marker, and I'm going to count, let's see, I'm going to pull this backwards so I can see. Okay, so what we are going to do is I put my stitch markers 20 stitches apart from each other. So this is where you bind it off. So we want them to be 20 stitches apart. So I counted from where I finished off 20 stitches. So I marked it right there, and then I marked it where you finished off the stitch before that. So that's where we are going to crochet from here all the way around back to here. So go ahead and take your crochet hook. Mm-hmm. And I am switching my color to coffee because this is the color now that I'm supposed to switch to. That's my son in the background. He wanted to be here with me to make this video. But I'm going to switch my color and I'll be right back. So I'm going to chain one. That counts as nothing. So we will be double crocheting into the same stitch. That's one. And we will be double crocheting all the way to the other side of the stitch marker. So this is going to be our last stitch, and we should have a total of, we will have a total of 60 double crochets around. If you want to go ahead and make it even by adding one more stitch for making it a total of 70, you can. And like I said, when you're creating the sweater, you can make it the sides as long as you want. This is how long I want the sides to be. So, you know, it's really up to you. So starting from here on, we're working rows. And all you have to do is chain one and sort of just turn your work facing this way. Now just chain one. So this is what we're going to be doing here on throughout the pattern. You are going to work as many rows as you want. I did, geez, I don't even remember how many I did. I measured from the neck here all the way down to the tail area, all the way at the bottom, until it got to about 25 inches long. So make it as long as you want. I'm making mine to 25 inches long. Junior, my brother's dog, is, I believe, 33 inches long. Let's see. Yeah, he's 33 inches long. So make it as long as you want. So chain one and double crochet into the same stitch. And this doesn't count as a double crochet, the chain one. So always make sure that you're going into there for a double crochet. And you are just going to be changing colors every four rows. And then when you get to this color coffee, you will only do two rows of this color. Because remember, we want the colors to match to the sweater. And if you're working with one color, then you know you don't have, of course, you don't have to change colors, which is really easy. Preferably, I like working with one color, but for this tutorial, I felt like doing something different than my last dog video. And I just wanted to thank everyone while I'm here for subscribing to my channel and for leaving great feedback. It's really nice and comforting to have started doing YouTube again and to have everyone show me so much love. So thank you to everybody that's watching this, that is subscribing and giving me feedback and just showing so much support. So thank you. So continue this. I'm going to finish my rows and remember to change colors. That's, you know, if you are following this tutorial. And if you are making the size for the extra large dog. It may be a little bit longer depending on how long the dog is. Just make sure that you measure the dog from the neck all the way down to its tail. Make your sweater that long, or however long that you want it. Just keep trying it on your dog as well. And I'm going to repeat what I am doing here for the next, I don't know, maybe the next 8 rows, and then I'm going to finish off. But I will let you guys know how many rows I did, and we will meet up, and I will be back in just a moment. Hi everyone, so I'm back, and I've came to the end of this round. I did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 rows in total since we finished off. And if you notice here, I accidentally made a boo-boo on this row right here. I was supposed to put 4 rows of this color, but I didn't. Must have gotten distracted somehow. Everybody's been calling me all day. We are going to attach a different color, of course, if you are following along with this tutorial. Let me pull this over here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take cafe latte, if that's how you say it. Starting off right here, I'm going to put 2. So there's 1, 2. And just crochet over your straggler. See that? Yeah. Go ahead and crochet in every row. Like that. So okay, so I'm back, and I have completed the large to extra large size dog sweater, and you can always adjust this. I mean, it's so adjustable. If you don't have exactly the measurements that my brother's dog has, all you have to do is just adjust the neck, which is the collar, the band, and do an increase. And then the length of the body, you can always make it as long as you want, like I said. So this is the back of the sweater. And this sweater is 25 inches long. Junior is 30 inches long. But I decided to make it for the sake of the tutorial, because I want to post this as soon as I can. And this is, of course, the middle, so then the dog doesn't soil the sweater. And you can always work in the round if you don't like this line, but I chained 1 so the line isn't so visible. And you have your armholes here. So this is my large to extra large size sweater. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And there's so many colors you can make this sweater out of, but I chose to use browns today. So thank you so much for watching, and if you want to share the pictures of your dog and his new sweater after completing your project, you can always send them to the email in the description of the video. Thank you so much for watching this video, and please subscribe for more tutorials that are to come. And my next video will be how to make a hoodie for your dog sweater. And it's been requested that I make a video for arm sleeves and for a hoodie, so I will be making that tutorial shortly. Bye!